thing is, like, I shared his work. Look at that, he's looking cool. I shared back with him. He's a top illustrator. Guess what he's going to do for me? Just give me some love from one. If I need to make a phone call, I can call him. So I'm creating
that connection.
Yeah. Alright, so my name is Jamal Collins. I go by Jay Word. Can I pull up something right here?
Sure.
Pull up my website phone. So I graduated in 97. Kind of brings back a lot of memories of me coming up here. When I first started going here, what's funny is that there was no internet in this building when I started school. I started in 91. I got to the campus, it was like, hey, we got this new thing called the internet. So we got this new thing called Photoshop, so I beta tested that too. So I graduated in 97. I started working at Price for High School. It's like one of the biggest accounting firms in the country in Cleveland, Ohio. I was at the DP Tower, that's like the second biggest building. 28th floor, 27th floor. I wore a suit every day. I hated them, and they hated me. You know, I kind of lost my true identity as an artist. I had stopped doing it for the love and started doing it for the money and the career and all that stuff. It was very boring work. It really wasn't so fulfilling to me at the time. Another weird thing that happened with the accounting firm is that when they merged with Cooper's, because they started out as Pricewaterhouse, when they merged with Cooper's, they came out with something called Brand Guidelines. Brand Guidelines is a set of colors, fonts, different sizes. You gotta follow these guidelines and follow the brand. It makes sense. But what happened was is they outsourced these Brand Guidelines to some guys in India, and they kind of left me out of work eventually. I started out with groups of like 6 designers. It came with a cookie cutter, Brand Guidelines, and that meant that grandma could come in learn the quick basic brand guidelines and she could do the design work. Make sense? So what I've been doing lately is I'm a teacher now. What's so weird about it is that I teach at Richmond High School, I teach after school, and I don't have a teaching license. I get photography jobs. I'm not really a photographer. I am, but you know, I put out a lot of content, I build a lot of relationships, and off these relationships I stand out. I do cinematography, I do photography, I do video, I talk, I give talks. I don't know if you guys are familiar with weapons of mass creation. Anybody heard of weapons of mass creation? Raise your hand. Weapons of mass creation, okay. So weapons of mass creation is a 3-day event in Cleveland. It's for designers, it's for entrepreneurs. It's almost like a TED talk for creators. Something that all you designers should go to. I gave my keynote last year, but I've been going for years. So I've been able to build these relationships with these guys, and I'm sat at the table with the top designers, top photographers, illustrators in Cleveland worldwide. So I got my recent press up there too. If you click on recent press, you can kind of see I got links to like the articles and stuff. And I mean, the thing was that I had to separate myself from designers because I was kind of coming mediocre. I was just a designer like everybody else. I wasn't really standing out much. Like I felt like.
So what did you do?
What did I do? I had to really build myself. I built a bunch of relationships. So I started like hitting the pavement a lot. I was going to all the art shows. I was going to the art museum.
Got me out there and see what's happening.
Yeah, I was going out there. I was shaking hands. I was telling people who I was. I started documenting what I was doing. So like all you guys, what you're doing right now, really, you should be really having like some type of shrink OBS or screen for a record. You designing that whole thing. And then you crunch and do the speed. Think how amazing it would be. Like you've been working on this huge project all semester, you've been doing video. So now you can separate yourself. So now you got levers.
So now they got like an identity for their work. I mean, for their creative.
Yes. So, because the thing is, the stuff is evolving so much. You gotta think about, like, 2 years ago, it was a bunch of guys sitting right here that graduated, and the year before that, the year after that, it's a whole bunch of guys like you looking for jobs.
So how do you differentiate yourself?
You got to build a brand around you and your content and what you're doing. Because everybody in here is unique. Everybody got a unique story, where you're from. You may be silly, you may be charismatic, you might have some type of interest in something else. You got to build that content around it. The thing is, like, I'm really no different. The reason why I'm different from everybody else is because I'm Jay Mark. You know what I'm saying? I got my own title, Jay Mark. I got a beard. I talk to kids. Go to my YouTube. So I talked at Weapons of Mass Creation. The thing is, I talk about design and social change. The whole idea about that is really changing the behavior of the youth and introducing them to design. Like, another thing that you guys should do is really use the social networks to build around your brand. All you guys should be on LinkedIn right now. Not, like, my daughter graduated from Bowling Green. She graduated 2 years ago. She's still working on her LinkedIn. The campus ain't going to tell y'all about LinkedIn and how to use it, because LinkedIn is just as good as Facebook. You can build content around that. You're going to get more looks. Before people just get on LinkedIn, and just everybody familiar with what LinkedIn is? It's like a professional Facebook. People just put their bullet points on there and just leave it static. Yeah, just click on the J word. I just want them to kind of see, like,
that one?
Yeah. So I post, you can kind of see, scroll down. I post a lot. So this is, it's up to 24K. But I do speed art too.
Click right here.
I do mine too. Like, the content you build, and this is the leverage you have over other companies. It's really no jobs. If you look it up graphic design right now, you may not really see a lot. You know what I'm saying? So the only way you're going to have leverage to open up a conversation is to have some work. You just inbox a guy directly. Like, I love your company. I don't care if it's nice to do this. Like, I would like to love to sit down and talk to you about, you know, maybe how I can add my expertise, or I can add some flavor to Adidas, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can find out, just do a little due diligence to find out who's making decisions in the design department. At night, you should have something.
Sure, I mean, you guys have to think, you have the world at your fingertips. You can research and find out who you want to work with. Not just take the first job that's offered. That's part of your research. Where do you want to be?
Yeah.
What do you want to do?
Yeah.
It's all right there. Easy. You don't have to go to the library anymore.
And this is kind of...
We'll go home now.
This is kind of like, this is what's separating me. This is how I'm getting a teaching job. I don't have a license. I'm a designer. I teach at Richmond High School. See what I'm saying? Why? I made the market come to me. It's because I've shown you inside the classroom with the class. Give you the content so you know exactly what you get when you get in there. Make sense? Alright, you see my intro. So I worked on this intro in Adobe After Effects.
How long did it take you to make
it? It ain't taking me long at all. I grabbed the template to do my video. I ain't gonna have time. You know, it's just all about the hack and getting it done. The thing is that what I started doing was, on Facebook, I started following, like, all designers, all artists completely. So I was catching up on what they was doing, where they was going. I'm going to the events and I'm meeting people. So the main thing is getting to know people, it's building a relationship. It's going to weapons of mass creation, it's going to these events. You know what I'm saying? Makes sense. Got it. You got questions?
Who's got questions?
So you see what I did? I'm telling a story. You see what the little guys are doing, the gang signs they needed. You know what I'm saying? They don't know nothing about this. So I'm coming back to give, you know, my expertise with them. I got my laptop. I connect with them. I show that connection people want to hire. I'm showing some empathy. I'm showing. You know, you get all warm and fuzzy about it, yes? I got it? You got questions? I know you do. No questions? Go ahead.
How do you think that design is working at
the end? Hey, yeah. I'm gonna tell you why graphic design is probably the best major in the world. It's because you can do so much. Like, I can compete with photographers. I landed a photography gig with St. Louis Foundation. So I'm doing photography, I'm doing video, I can do marketing. Only secret you need to figure out is marketing. So if I would say take some extra time in doing some marketing to understand how to market yourself and market your work, you know what I'm saying? Because you can set up a website, you can do all this content. Content's king, y'all know that. If you follow Gary Vaynerchuk, if you follow Casey Neistat, you know it just take an instant to go viral and you just put out the content. You can just put all your illustrations, like he was asking, put all your illustrations on Instagram, and now you're known as a practitioner, as an illustrator, you don't get to work. You should be on Dribbble.
So, so you're not only doing creative work, but you're presenting it, and you also have a facility to write about your experience.
Yes.
To communicate. I mean, that's the whole package where, you know, you can think of what you need to say. Writing is extremely important for proposals, for getting your ideas out there.
Yes.
Can you talk about writing?
Yes. Well, that's all about content. So if you're not comfortable with doing video, you should be writing your content. You should be doing a podcast too. So podcasts, all of this is content creation. If you can do all three, you're going to really crush it. Because you can get on Medium. Medium is like a free platform. You should be on Behance for all your work. Everybody on here on Behance.net? Okay, Behance.net is a free online portfolio website. You get your own URL. So that'd be Behance.com/Jamal Collins. You'll see some of my old stuff on it. But you can get your own, so you don't have to be like, well, I don't have a website, I can't afford my WordPress right now. You should be on Behance and follow all designers from wherever you're going. If you're going to Texas, you should be following any designers, illustrators, and see what your competition is doing. You see what I'm saying? So you gotta follow the market and see what your competition is doing and follow all the top guys on LinkedIn too. LinkedIn is your professional web, it's like your professional resume online platform for you. But what's beautiful about LinkedIn is that you can put content on here like it's Facebook.
So I put a portfolio.
Yeah, it's like a portfolio. So I post my videos on there. I get looks from New York, from Columbus. I got creators looking at my stuff. Like, I got so much activity because you can check the analytics. Twitter too, so I hit all those networks. I've been on the news based off of Twitter, based off of Instagram.
Right. So, I know what you're getting on the internet a lot, whether you know, try to type yourself and get you. He said, go find you.
Definitely. How they gonna know you? How they gonna know you exist? You gotta think about it. Like, I'm doing all this cool stuff in the city. I'm doing all this stuff. If I never recorded, you would never know. I would never been at Richmond High School. Okay, Tri-C reached out to me and said, we want to teach a class, we want you to teach it as adjunct. So you gotta make the market come to you. So you gotta show how cool you are. You should have a camera record you drawing that and do a speed lapse of you drawing it on your YouTube channel and monetize that. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So everybody know about how to monetize a YouTube channel, yes? Alright, so you should have that channel monetized. You guys are cool, you guys are young, younger than me. If I had it, I would be crushing even more. I'm just old, that's why my numbers ain't up. Well, I'm going here. Yeah.
So basically, every project you have in this school, you have to find a way into it to make it your own. This is what's going to set you aside. Everybody's got the same work, and you've got portfolios year after year. What makes you unique? That's what you're all saying. And then also, promote yourself.
You can't have pleasure in life without skill. But it isn't a unpleasant task to learn a skill. If the teacher, in the first place, gets you fascinated with it. There is immense pleasure in learning